Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I am going to explain you the basic comparison in between OSI model and TCP IP model. I have already explained complete details regarding OSI model, and at that time I have told you OSI model, that is a reference model, and right now in 2023 there are some practicals model for computer network like TCP IP model, and I have told you like see all the other models which are right now working in current scenario in 2023, those are based on OSI model only. So here I'll explain you the basic comparison that will give you more clarity regarding how exactly all those models are, right? So as I have told you, see, OSI model, that is a reference model, and TCP IP model, that is a practical model right now implemented in 2023. If you see my previous video, in that I have explained OSI model is there based on 7 layers, right? Here at application side, user will be working with application. So first layer will be application layer, then there will be presentation layer. In presentation layer, we perform various tasks like we convert characters into binary, and there are few more tasks like data compression and security that is being provided. Session layer, that is responsible for session establishment, session management and session termination. After session layer, there is a transport layer. In transport layer, we provide segmentation of data. So combination of these three layer provides data, and that data that is been converted into segments over here inside transport layer. Once we are having segment, those segments are converted into packets at network layer. In network layer, we are adding IP addresses of source and destination along with packets, right? So here segments are converted into packets by addition of source and destination IP address. Now those packets are converted into frames at data link layer. In frames with packet, we will be adding MAC address of source and destination along with tail. And at last, there is a physical layer in which those frames are there in terms of binary, and those binary data that is been converted into signals. So that is how OSI model is there, that I have already explained in my previous video. Now let us try to understand these 7 layers with respect to TCP IP model. I have told you TCP IP model is based on this OSI model only, but how structure is there, let us try to understand that. So when it comes to TCP IP model, in that there is first layer, that is application layer, which will be giving you data, right? And you should know, my dear students, in TCP IP model, combination of these three layers, that will be single layer, that is application layer. And while I was explaining you OSI model, at that time I have told you, here many of the practical applications that is performing all these three tasks, right? Like current browser, that is performing the task of these three layers, like application layer, presentation layer and session layer. All these three tasks that is being performed in current applications, right? And it is directly giving data. So in application layer of TCP IP model, how many things are happening? Application task is happening where you can write your URL of browser, or you can access Skype application, right? In presentation layer, what we were been doing, we were been converting given characters into binary, as well as we were been performing data compression. And security issues, that is been resolved over here in presentation layer. So that is happening over here in this single layer, as well as session management, session establishment, all those things were been happening over here. That is also added over here in this application layer. So combination of these three layer, that is application layer, which is there in TCP IP model, right? Now when it comes to next layer, that is transport layer over here. So that is same as transport layer inside TCP IP model, where TCP IP protocol that we use. And here the data which is there over here at the output of this application layer, now that is getting converted into segments. So the raw file, which is data, now that is bisected into small segments. Once you have segments, then we will be giving numbering to those segments, like segment numbers, or you can say sequence number, that is given over here, as well as port number that is been assigned. Inside port number, what we do is we give processes to various segments, right? So at transport layer, output will be segments over here. So that is same as OSI model, right, with TCP IP model. Now next layer with TCP IP model, that will be network layer, and that is same as network layer of OSI model, right? Here IPv4, that is the protocol which we use. IPv4, that we use it for logical addressing, right? So segments are converted into packets. So what is the meaning of packet? Packet is segment plus source IP address plus destination IP address that we added over here in network layer, right? And when it comes to TCP/IP model, last layer, that is a combination of data link layer and physical layer, that is referred as physical layer. In data link layer, what we were been doing over here? In data link layer, we were been converting those packets which are output of this network into frames. So what is the meaning of frame? Frame means packets plus we are adding physical address like MAC address, right, of source and destination, and plus tail bits that we are adding. So packets are converted into frames over here, and along with that we also perform task of physical layer by converting frames into bits and signals, right? So TCP/IP model, that is having in total 4 layers: application, transport, network and physical, while with OSI model we are having 7 layers, right? But all the tasks remain same over here. Only thing is we are combining these 3 layers over here to form application layer at TCP/IP, and at last data link and physical layer, that is getting combined and that is forming physical layer. Here one thing that you need to understand, see, with OSI layer, these 3 layers, layer 7, 6 and 5, that is giving data, right? Here TCP/IP model, that gives data over here after application layer. This data, that is a huge file that you can say, or a large file that you can say. Now when you want to transmit that over a network, at the time you need to bisect those files into small segments, right? The reason is large file should not be forwarded over the network, otherwise there can be major issues, like as if large file is getting corrupted, in that case again you will have to resend the large file. For example, let us say you want to download 1 GB video, and as if entire 1 GB video as a large file that we are forwarding over the network, and as if some data is getting corrupted, then again you will have to forward that large file of size of 1 GB video. But as if you bisect that 1 GB video into 1000 parts, right, then part size will be 1 MB only. Now as if you forward 1 MB file size over the network, and as if let us say 5 files are getting corrupted, then again we can resend it, and we can that combine all those files to make a large file. So here what we do is we bisect this data into small parts and make it to segments over here, right? After the segments, output of transport layer will be segment, that will be given to network layer. Here network layer forms packets from the segments, where along with the segments we are adding source and destination IP address at network layer, and it is forming packets. And once these packets are given to this physical layer, here physical layer is a combination of data link and physical of OSI model. So here we are converting these packets into frame. In frame, what we do? In frame, we add MAC address of source and destination, as well as we add some tail bits for error correction, right? And those frames are the sequence of bits that we need to convert in terms of signals. And why do we need to convert that into signals? The reason is you may be using any medium, like you may be using wired medium or wireless medium. In wired medium, usually we use Ethernet cable. Ethernet cable is made up of copper, so here you will be doing electrical signaling. In physical medium, you may be using optical cable, in which you may need to convert signals into light form, right? And in wireless medium, you will have to convert those bits into electromagnetic waves, right? So that is how layer by layer formation is there with OSI model and TCP/IP model. I hope it is clear to you. Still, if anything that you would like to share it with me, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.